people often came up and said, you should turn this into a book. And at that time, I had 7 or 8 laws, and I like alliteration, so I really thought about what drives likability. When I think about defining likability, I don't think about somebody who needs to be my best friend or who I want to go out and party with. I think about somebody who I have a foundation of trust and ease in conversation and a natural connection, somebody who I just like being around. Why is that important in business? Well, it's critical in business. Think about that store you like shopping in. Think about that client that you enjoy working for or a vendor that you enjoy working with. When you are working with people that you like, your productivity increases. It's a direct correlation. You want to do well for them, you're going to get more opportunities as well because they like working with you. I think the best thing I can tell new hires is attitude over aptitude. I'm really tying into that law of energy. Do everything with a smile. Be happy to do it. Nothing's beneath you. I remember my first job at Arthur Andersen. I was making a big old $31,000 a year, and they were sending me to photocopy. And I'm thinking, happy to do it. You're paying me this much to photocopy. Here we go. Hit the button. So doing it with a smile makes people want to give you more opportunities. So you want to think about listening to what you're hearing going on in the organization, so then you can apply curiosity and ask some questions so that you can find those opportunities. But in terms of pitfalls, be careful of what are the rules of the road within your organization. You want to be careful of political landmines and the cultural implications. So if it's inappropriate to go knock on a partner's door, don't do it. But I love the idea of stopping by their assistant's desk and chatting with them. When I think about managing, it really is all founded in communication. We're constantly communicating with that team, and to do it effectively, you want to think about flexing our communication style. We want to learn how they want to be talked to, not the way we want to be talked to. So we're changing from the kindergarten golden rule of do unto others as you want done unto yourself to the platinum rule of do unto others as they want done unto themselves. And that's really also going to come into play if you take a training on how to give effective feedback. Because some people like it direct, and some people would like it with a little bit more prefacing or tact. And so that's a great training for managers. Leading with emotional intelligence is also foundational skills in thinking about how do I motivate my team and how do I delegate effectively based on their preferences, their styles, and how do I stay in tune with the energy that they have in the organization. I truly live these laws, and this is my heart and soul on those pages.